I'm John Batchelor with Larry Kudlow, who's the author of a new book just published today and reviewed very favorably by John Tamney and Iris Stoll, two very careful commentators about the economy and about politics. Iris Stoll has a wonderful book about JFK as a conservative. But this book, the new book that Larry's publishing with his colleague Brian Dmitrovic, JFK and the Reagan Revolution, A Secret History of American Prosperity. It's about prosperity. It's about the tax cuts of 1962-63 and Ronald Reagan's tax cuts. But in this, compelling to me, is a case made for the connection between civil rights, the civil rights success of the 1960s that happened after John F. Kennedy's death, and tax cuts. Here's how it goes. A. Philip Randolph was president of the Brotherhood of Sleeping Car Porters. He's a critical figure in the transformation of America from the Jim Crow era to civil rights and the liberation of the American people today. He sees in the early 1960s, late 50s, early 60s, that the poor growth numbers, the low economic growth, was blocking any progress that the African-American community in America could make after the Brown v. Board of Education was seen to be a landmark, a turning point. The idea that segregated schools were not acceptable. That was 1954. But there was this long period in the 50s, Eisenhower, where there was no advance. There was the 1957 Civil Rights Act, but it was half measures. Randolph saw that he needed growth to liberate everyone, including the African-American community that was at the bottom of the totem pole. Larry makes that case here with his colleague Brian Dmitrovic, and they make the additional case. And Larry, I want you to comment on this. We have a couple minutes. The connection between taxes, lowering taxes, which goes to growth, and civil rights. What was the connection, Larry?
Well, the way that worked is that in the 1950s, John, contrary to a lot of urban legends, the American economy was very sluggish and very slow and suffered through three recessions. It was not the golden age that people describe. So, despite some good civil rights legislation with respect to voting and housing and fair practices and what have you, blacks were not gaining. The jobs weren't there. As you noted, the unemployment rate was very high. And good thinkers like Randolph, and by the way, Martin Luther King basically bought into this, realized without growth, they are not going to, African-American communities are not going to be able to realize their dreams. And so the job to be done here was to break up an unholy coalition of Dixiecrat Democrats, racist Dixiecrat Democrats, who didn't want any civil rights legislation at all, and what they thought were their allies up north, the unions, and the working blue-collar people in general. And they argued, you know, this economy is no good, and blacks are taking your jobs because of all this legislation, and we got to stop this. So they voted against the tax cuts. They voted against it.
Because they didn't want growth. They wanted the status quo of segregation.
Yes, they wanted the status quo of segregation, and unfortunately, a lot of union leaders wanted the status quo where their senior people had jobs. Now, Kennedy helped to break that, and so did Lyndon Johnson. This is a very important part of our book. To get those tax cuts through, the first tranche was finished in late 63 after the tragic assassination. That was done in the House. They had to get it through the Senate. LBJ is the president, and LBJ brings on, he breaks this thing up. First of all, he threatens the Dixiecrats are going to lose all their powers.
We've got a minute, Larry. Go ahead.
Yeah, he gets George Meany of the AFL-CIO to be on board with economic growth because Meany saw that his workers weren't increasing their living standards, and Meany understood that we had to be strong to defeat Soviet communism. That was a huge turnaround, LBJ's best moment. So I just come back to this argument, John. You lower taxes, you have a strong dollar, limit government, as much free trade as possible, grow the economy back to its long-run trend, which is 3.5%. People will be happier, they'll be more optimistic, they'll have more take-home pay, they'll have better jobs, and they'll have a better outlook on the future for their kids. They won't be pointing the fingers at all these other groups. That's one of the reasons why growth is so important and essential to the American psyche.
JFK and the Reagan Revolution, A Secret History of American Prosperity, just published. Larry Kudlow, Lawrence Kudlow, and Brian Dmitrovic. I'm John Batchelor. This is The John Batchelor Show.